Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable President of India is about to enter Punjab Engineering College. May I request all of you to kindly take your seats. I request all those who are standing to kindly take their seats, please. We can see some of the volunteers in the passage. Kindly clear the passage and take your positions. The student volunteers, may I request you to kindly take your positions. I would also request all of you to kindly switch off your mobile phones, please. Today, on this auspicious day, the Honorable President of India, Sri Ram Nath Kovind ji, Honorable Governor of Punjab and Administrator, Sri Banwari Lal Purohit ji, and Honorable Governor of Haryana, Sri Bandaru Dattatreya ji, would also be inaugurating some of our facilities. So they are first going to proceed towards the inaugural sites, where the Centenary Hall, the Centenary Himalaya Hostel Extension, the main gate, and the Semiconductor Research Center is going to be inaugurated on the site. The entire inaugural ceremony could be viewed on the LEDs in front of you, so you'll be able to view it live. Following which, Honorable President of India would be proceeding towards the main venue.
A very good evening to one and all. Today is a momentous occasion marking the
So as you can see, Honorable President of India, along with other dignitaries, advisor, Chairman Board of Governors, Director, and other faculty members, is now unveiling the plaque for the Centenary Hall. This is the unveiling of the Centenary Gate, which is right at the entrance, the main gate. The Semiconductor Research Center has also been inaugurated today. It is a state-of-the-art facility for the semiconducting material growth, micro, nano, electronic, device design, fabrication, and characterizes. This facility comprises of four clean rooms, laboratories of class 1000 and 10,000 dedicated for the chemical processing of semiconductors, material growth, deposition, lithography, with a feature size of 1 micrometer and electrical testing up to 20 gigahertz. It is one of its kind in and around Chandigarh, other than ISRO's semiconductor laboratory in Mohali. SRC, the facility that you can see on the LEDs, we're displaying a video. It has been established with a generous funding of about 5 crores from Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, under Fund for Improvement of S&T Infrastructure Scheme, given to Punjab Engineering College, CERC, DST, and DRDO. Announcements with all of you. As soon as the President of India enters the main stage and comes on the main stage, I request all of you to stand, rise, and you'd remain standing for the national anthem. We'll immediately play national anthem as soon as the dignitaries come onto the dais. I'll again request all of you to kindly turn off your mobile phones, please. Right now, the Honorable President of India is signing the visitor book, being there at the Centenary Hall. They'll be here any moment. ladies and gentlemen, Honorable President of India. Does not yet arrive. Request all of you to please rise for the national anthem. I apologize. The dignitaries will now be receiving the Honorable President of India. Till then, I think I would request you to be seated. I'll again have to request you, as soon as he enters the main venue, I request all of you to rise at that time. Ladies and gentlemen, Honorable President of India, please rise. Request all of you to remain standing for the national anthem. President of India, Sri Ram Nath Kovind ji, the chief guest at the centenary year celebrations of Punjab Engineering College, Chandigarh, Sri Banwarilal Purohit ji, Honorable Governor of Punjab and Administration, UT Chandigarh, and our guest of honor, Sri Bandaru Dattatreya ji, Honorable Governor of Haryana, and our guest of honor, Sri Dharampal ji, advisor to UT Administrator, Sri Rajendra Gupta ji, Chairman Board of Governors of the Institute, Professor Baldev Sethia, Director PEC, senior officers and representatives from the governments, distinguished guests, esteemed alumni, members from the media, to all the students, to all who are here today, and to all who are virtually attending across the world, congratulations. It is an honor to honor this highly revered audience who has gathered here to celebrate 100 years of glorious existence and Foundation Day of our prestigious institution, Punjab Engineering College. It is a moment of great pride and honor for the entire Punjab Engineering College fraternity and all those who have been associated directly or indirectly with PEC. Very few institutes in India have an opportunity to celebrate such a remarkable milestone. On behalf of PEC, I extend my gratitude to the Government of India and Chandigarh Administration for their constant backing through good times and challenging times over the past 100 years. To students, faculty, staff, administration, and alumni for their partnership and leadership in the exciting and challenging voyage of transformation. To PEC's remarkable, consistent, and dependable supporters, without whom our dogged pursuit of a mission would not be possible. We will have a traditional and auspicious lamp lighting ceremony as a tribute to Mother Saraswati, the goddess of knowledge. I request the advisor, Chairman Board of Governors, and Director PEC to kindly escort the Honorable President of India and other dignitaries present on the dais for the lamp lighting ceremony. So please. Felicitations. May I request Shri Dharampalji, advisor to the UT administration, who's also the former student of Punjab Engineering College, to kindly felicitate Honorable President of India, Shri Ram Nath Kovindji, with the memento. Thank you, sir. I'd now like to request Chairman Board of Governors, Shri Rajinder Guptaji, to kindly felicitate Shri Banwari Lal Purohitji, Honorable Governor of Punjab and Administrator, UT Chandigarh, and our guest of honor with a memento. May I now request Director PEC, Dr. Baldev Sethia, to kindly felicitate Shri Pandaru Dattatreji, Honorable Governor of Haryana, our guest of honor, with a memento. Ladies and gentlemen, the memento carries the photograph of the auditorium clipped in the year 1953 when the first Legislative Assembly of Punjab was hosted in PEC Auditorium. The auditorium of PEC is one of the most historically significant buildings of Punjab Engineering College. I would now like to invite Professor Baldev Sethia, Director, Punjab Engineering College, for his welcome speech and introduction. Prior to that, I must acknowledge that within 100 days of his taking over the Institute as its director, he has demonstrated exemplary leadership and completely dedicated himself to the institution. Sir, please.
Honorable President of India, Shri Ram Nath Kovindji, whom we are honored to have as the chief guest at the inaugural function of the centenary celebrations of Punjab Engineering College, Chandigarh. Our guests of honor, Shri Banwari Lal Purohitji, Honorable Governor of Punjab and Administrator, Union Territory of Chandigarh, Shri Bandaru Dattatreji, Honorable Governor of Haryana, Shri Dharampal, Advisor to the UT Administrator, Shri Rajendra Gupta, Chairman Board of Governors of the Institute, distinguished guests, friends from the media, members of the faculty, alumni, staff, dear students, ladies and gentlemen. At the outset, I wish to extend my warm greetings and compliments to this August gathering on the centenary celebrations of Punjab Engineering College, Chandigarh. On behalf of the Institute, it's my proud privilege and honor to heartily welcome the Honorable President of India, Shri Ram Nath Kovindji, our chief guest on this landmark occasion in the history of the Institute. On completing 100 years of glorious existence, today is the day when the Institute commences its year-long centenary celebrations. The presence today of the stately personality of our Honorable President lends the greatest honor and status to this function. Welcome, sir, to the land that is popularly known by the metaphor of City Beautiful. On this beautiful land is located the historical temple of learning, Punjab Engineering College, PEC. Welcome to PEC, sir. Today, it's history being crafted, as we are privileged also to have the gracious presence of both the governors of Punjab and Haryana on the same stage in PEC. The Honorable Governor of Punjab, who is also the administrator of Chandigarh, has always been a source of inspiration for the Institute. I welcome you, sir. In the very same breath, I come forward to welcome Shri Bandaru Dattatreji, the Governor of Haryana, who by his benign presence here today has extended his blessings and moral support to us for the celebrations. It's my honor to welcome Srimati Kiran Kher, the Member of Parliament, Chandigarh, who is joining the program in the virtual mode. Shri Dharampal, advisor to the administrator and an alumnus of PEC, and Shri Rajendra Gupta, chairman board of governors of the institute. Allow me to extend a warm and hearty welcome to all the distinguished guests, officials, alumni, the media, faculty, staff and students present in the August gathering, and also those who are a part of this celebration online. Ladies and gentlemen, it was 9th November 1921, 100 years back, almost to the day, when the foundation stone of the institute was laid by the then governor of Punjab, Sir Edward MacLagan, in Mughalpura, Lahore, in undivided India. The college was then known as Mughalpura Technical College, which was soon changed to MacLagan Engineering College in the honor of Sir Edward. In 1939, the college was rechristened as Punjab College of Engineering and Technology. After independence, the institute was shifted to the present campus of IIT Roorkee as East Punjab College of Engineering to distinguish it from its roots in Lahore. 3 years later, the prefix East was dropped, and finally in 1953, it was shifted to its new and the present campus in Chandigarh. In the year 2003, the institute marked yet another historic milestone when it was granted the status of a deemed to be university. The illustrious history of PEC is mirrored by its outstanding graduates. We are an alma mater to numerous notable and esteemed corporate wizards and nation-building heroes such as Professor Satish Dhawan, the first chairman of the Indian Space Commission, Dr. Kalpana Chawla, the first Indian woman in space, Shri Dinesh Khanna, the first Indian to win an Asian badminton title, and not to forget the cine and TV artist Jaspal Bhatti. 100 years back, what started with barely 50 students admitted to electrical and mechanical engineering today stands strong with 8 BTech, 12 MTech, and PhD programs in all disciplines. Ladies and gentlemen, may I submit that an institute that has given the Indian Institute of Technology Delhi its founder director in Professor R.N. Dogra, an institute that has mentored neighboring institutes like NIT Kurukshetra and NIT Jalandhar, deserves to be declared an institution of national importance of the country. I feel this is a gift most befitting this unique occasion. Ladies and gentlemen, personally for me, it's a matter of great honor and privilege to be heading an institute as prestigious as Punjab Engineering College, Chandigarh. The honor is further enhanced when this takes place in the 100th year of the glorious existence of the institute and the Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav of the nation. I do understand that while it's a unique distinction, it also carries with it the huge responsibility of taking this great institute to even greater heights. I humbly seek your cooperation, guidance, and blessings in this regard. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I once again extend a warm and hearty welcome to you all. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, on this momentous occasion, students of Punjab Engineering College have produced a documentary reflecting our journey and rich legacy. From scrounging through the mountain of newspaper articles spanning the years 1900 to 2020, to reaching out to our alumni across the globe and consulting various experienced professors for insights into PEC's history, our team worked tirelessly to collect the remnants of PEC's legacy. May we now present to you a documentary on 100 years of the glorious past of Punjab Engineering College.
The Odyssey of Punjab Engineering College. Situated at the foothills of Shivalik, the legacy of this 149 acres of sprawling green campus dates back to 100 years. It all started in Mughalpura. dates back to 100 years. It all started in Mughalpura, Lahore, when in 1921, a technical institute by the name of Mughalpura Technical College was founded by the then Lieutenant Governor of Punjab, Sir Edward Douglas MacLagan. While in Lahore, we served as an alma mater to Padma Vibhushan Satish Dhawan. Dr. Dhawan graduated in 1945 with specialization in mechanical engineering.
The stroke of the midnight hour, when the world sleeps, India will awake to life and freedom.
In 1950, we were renamed to Punjab Engineering College. The temporary life at Roorkee lasted until 1953, when a present campus at the city beautiful Chandigarh got ready. Our auditorium was requisitioned by the government to hold sessions of the Legislative Assembly. Amidst the rising tensions with China in 1962, Air Vice Marshal Harjinder Singh, our alumnus, approached Peck about starting an undergraduate program in aeronautical engineering. We agreed, and Peck gave India its first 17 aeronautical undergraduates. Astronaut Kalpana Chawla, the first woman of Indian origin to go into outer space, graduated from aeronautical engineering in 1982.
The whole spaceship was glowing in silver light from the moon, and the attitude was changing, and you really felt that you were in a spaceship headed somewhere.
In 2003, Peck became a deemed to be university. Punjab Engineering College has been able to achieve greater heights and glory thanks to our visionary leaders. Professor R.N. Dogra played a pivotal role in establishing the institute at Chandigarh. Dr. Baldev Sethia, our present director, is currently holding the baton to strive the institute towards excellence. The illustrious history of Peck is mirrored by its famous alumni. Punjab Engineering College has trained and fostered its students for over a century, preparing them to represent and serve the country. Our graduates have penned down stories about their achievement and dedication. Padma Bhushan and comic Jaspal Bhatti graduated from Peck in 1978 as an electrical engineer.
भाई जरा ध्यान से फेंकना था।
आप लोग भी रास्ते में खड़े हो, अंदर नहीं बैठ सकते क्या?
Punjab Engineering College has produced numerous nation-building heroes and notable corporate visits. Punjab Engineering College, Chandigarh, today stands as a testimony to being one of the most prestigious and prominent institute of the nation. It was established in the same year as Chandigarh and has always been a cornerstone to its development and glory.
Associated who have created this beautiful history for Punjab Engineering College. And coming next, we have a folk dance of Punjab called Bhangra being performed by our students. A big round of applause to students of Punjab Engineering College.
Ali
Enjoyed the very energetic tone and the equally vivacious dance. The boys had the audience on their feet literally while they danced on the stage. May I now request Honorable President of India, Sri Ram Nath Kovind ji, to kindly release a special postal cover commemorating the centenary year celebrations of Punjab Engineering College. Ladies and gentlemen, the special cover showcases the old building of Mughalpura Engineering College, Lahore, on the left side, and to the right is the present auditorium of Punjab Engineering College in Chandigarh, India, with the emblem of Chandigarh. Thank you, sir. I would now like to request Sri Banwarilal Purohit ji, Honorable Governor of Punjab and Administrator UT Chandigarh, to present the coffee table book prepared by Punjab Engineering College to the Honorable President of India. Thank you, sir. To imprint the 100 years of history of PEC, the Institute has bought out this coffee table book, which incorporates significant history excerpts, anecdotes, biographies, archives, stories of alumni, past directors, and more. The coffee table book also features the photographs of the foundation stone of PEC, formerly Mughalpura Engineering College, laid in 1921 at Lahore, copy of degrees issued to luminaries like Dr. Satish Dhawan, speeches of principal of PEC and founder director IIT Delhi Professor R.N. Dogra, and so many other treasured articles. Having collected the data and photographs in their crude form, we had an amazing team who consolidated the entire collection to a breathing memoir of PEC to give readers a beautiful and lovely experience. I'd now like to request Sri Banwarilal Purohit ji, Honorable Governor of Punjab and Administrator UT Chandigarh, our guest of honor, to please give his speech. Sir.
Honorable President of India, Sri Ram Nath ji Kovind, Honorable Governor of Haryana, Sri Bandaru ji Dattatreya, Sri Dharampal ji Advisor UT, Sri Rajendra Gupta ji Chairman, Board of Governors of PEC, Professor Baldev Sethia, Director PEC, dear faculty members, staff members, students, and ladies and gentlemen, I am elated to be with you all today to celebrate 100 years of Punjab Engineering College, Chandigarh. As the Governor of Punjab and Administrator of Chandigarh, it gives me immense pleasure to greet and congratulate the administration, faculty, staff, students, and alumni on this propitious occasion. This Institute of Excellence and Eminence has provided enriching technical education since its inception in 1921. The history of Punjab Engineering College draws close connections to the needs and expectations of the nation in the past, the Industrial Revolution and emerging technologies. In 1962, when it was felt that the Indian Air Force did not have enough engineers to maintain its aircrafts, PEC proved that it could fulfill any target and goals to serve and protect the nation's integrity by giving India its first 17 graduate aeronautical engineers in 1964. Later in 1982, the newly established aeronautical department produced one of the most celebrated alumni of the institution, named Kalpana Chawla. The first Indian woman to go to space. Over the years, PEC has always provided future generations with extraordinary facilities and resources. It has been a guiding light for many young intellectuals and has produced some of the most refined talent this world has ever seen. The glory of the alumni of this institute is evident from Sri Dharampal, advisor to the administrator, sharing the stage with me today, being a graduate of this prestigious institution. This institute has also given the nation dignitaries like the Satish Dhawan, who is regarded as the father of experimental fluid dynamics research. Dr. Dhawan was also the first chairman of the Indian Space Commission. Sri Jaspal Bharti, an acclaimed strategist, Mr. Sandeep Bakshi, the MD and CEO, ICICI Bank, Vandana Verma, Chief Engineer, March 2020, Perseverance, Robotic Operations, NASA, are a few of the most distinguished alumni this institution has had. PEC has always valued the importance of formal education and a compassionate mind equally. Throughout these years, PEC has not only created exceptional leaders, but has also taken the bar of quality education a notch higher. After over a year and a half of lockdowns and facing so many challenges that the pandemic brought as a society, we are blessed to stand here and celebrate such a momentous occasion of this esteemed institution. The strength of character shown in the spirit of perseverance makes PEC a gem of a higher education institute. The guiding light of a mentor is of utmost importance in shaping the future and personality of an individual, and this institute has established itself over the years in successfully being able to do what, with the help of its considerate and supportive teachers and staff members. The National Education Policy 2020, the brainchild of our Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji, has taken special care to incorporate the vision of Swami Vivekananda and places great emphasis on technical and vocational education, professionals and skill-oriented education. In order to educate youth to become self-reliant with dignity, National Education Policy 2020 has also taken a huge step by liberating education from the shackles of compartmentalization into science versus arts, humanities, making learning flexible, humanistic, and oriented towards making educated youth noble citizens and good human beings. Our ancient spiritual texts explain the relationship between the teacher and the student as to how both have to grow together in the process of learning. This institute is recognized worldwide as a leader in the field of engineering education and research. The level of research in PEC has undoubtedly gone up in past years with the advent of more research and development facilities. In the year 2018, PC signed a memorandum of understanding with Siemens, following which Siemens opened their state-of-art labs within the institute with an investment of 100 crore rupees. Our future progress will depend increasingly on our ability to innovate, to devise efficient process for the industrial sector and better solutions for governance. For that, it is necessary to permeate the spirit of innovation to all sectors, business, government, education and society. Our Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi has been spearheading the Indian innovation strategy to focus on generating ideas that promote inclusive growth and benefit those at the bottom of the socio-economic pyramid. There are many grassroots innovations that can be developed into suitable products if provided with technological support. Our higher academic institutions must play an important role in mentoring such innovative endeavors. PC has built links with peer universities and institutes, both at the national and international levels, to enhance research and enrich its educational programs. As a result, the alumni have distinguished themselves through their achievements and contributions to the industry, academics, research, business, government, and social domains. The graduates of this institute have been outgoing to be the drivers of our economy and development, our success in taking advantage to the demographic dividend depends upon how we convert our youth into productive human resources through education, skills and values. As the institute steps into its centenary year, I wish PEC all the glory and success. I would also like to express my delight in being a part of the centenary celebration of this esteemed institution. Let us all continue to strive together to build this institute as a world-class institution of excellence and contribute to India's role as Vishwa Guru. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to invite Honorable President of India, Sri Ram Nath Kovindji, the chief guest, to address the August gathering. Sir.
Governor of Punjab and Administrator of Union Territory, Chandigarh, Sri Banwari Lal Purohitji, Governor of Haryana, Sri Bandaru Dattatrayji, Advisor to Administrator of Union Territory, Chandigarh, Sri Dharampalji, Chairman Board of Governors, Sri Rajendra Guptaji, Director, Professor Baldev Sethiaji, students, faculty, and other staff members, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is a moment of pride for me as I stand amid you to celebrate the centenary of the Punjab Engineering College. Such moments are rare in history. Institutions like the PEC are not just educational institutions, but are among centers of nation building. For here, you nurture talent and create the leaders of tomorrow. The Punjab Engineering College, a deemed university now, has a rich legacy. Its roots go back to 9th December 1921, when its foundation was laid as Mughalpura Technical College at Lahore by Sir Edward Douglas MacLagan. From the humble beginning with only 50 students, the PEC has evolved into a vibrant knowledge center at Chandigarh, with hundreds of students receiving professional learning in different disciplines at this campus. Punjab has always played a pivotal role in the history of our country, be it as the hub of Indus Valley civilization or as the Sapt Sindhu region of the Vedic period. Punjab has made a mark since times immemorial. Being a border state of our country, it has been among the first to feel the social political churnings caused by external influences. What is most important is that it has been a prominent symbol of Indian culture and civilization all over the world, be it spiritual traditions or modern technology. Achievements of this land are shining glories of our countries. Ladies and gentlemen, I am happy to learn that the alumni of your institute have brought immense fame to our country. I cannot help but recall the name of Professor Satish Dhawan, an extraordinary scientist who led India's space program through rapid growth and spectacular achievements. He is considered by the Indian scientist community to be the father of experimental fluid dynamics research. My esteemed predecessor, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, considered him not only as a guru, but also one of the three teachers in his life whom he held in the highest esteem. Such people are not just good professionals, but are great institution builders. It is also an honor for all of us to know that PEC has always risen to the needs of the nation. In the early 1960s, when it was felt that our country needed the services of aeronautical engineers, the Indian Air Force had approached the PEC. It was in no time that the urgent need was met by shifting students from other disciplines of engineering into the final year of specialization in aeronautical engineering. The faculty for this subject were from the Indian Institute of Science. Coincidentally, the director of IAISC at that time was none other than Professor Satish Dhawan, an illustrious alumnus of your college. It was through this joint effort with IAISC that PEC created history as being the first engineering college to give India its first batch of 17 graduate aeronautical engineers in 1964. Ladies and gentlemen, when the foundations of an institute have such a glorious and inspiring past, its students are bound to have higher ambitions in mind. Such ambitions were personified in Dr. Kalpana Chawla, an astronaut engineer, and the first woman of Indian origin to travel in space. She continues to be an ideal, inspiring millions across the world. I am glad to know that your institute has established the Kalpana Chawla Chair of Geospatial Technology. Today, we are in an era when rote learning must be kept aside and the idea of research in education has to be promoted. Our new national education policy is a guiding light for all of us, as it encourages research and development. Education under this policy will move from content heavy towards learning more about how to think critically and solve problems, how to be creative and multidisciplinary, and how to innovate, adapt, and absorb new material in ever-changing fields of study. The curriculum will include basic arts, humanities, sports and languages, and it will be based on our culture and values. I am told that the PEC has already been well ahead on the path of research and development. I am happy that on the occasion of the centenary of PEC, a state-of-the-art semiconductor research facility is being inaugurated on the campus. It is remarkable that such facilities promoting R&D are not new to this institute, as there have been previous collaborations with government and private organizations for establishing such ventures for the benefit of students. As you know, the Siemens Center of Excellence in Manufacturing is an example worth emulating by other universities. I would also like to commend the PEC for continuous collaborations with other prestigious institutions like the IITs, PGI, and ISRO. Such steps are helpful towards realizing the goal of excellence in application-oriented research. Such industry-institute interface will also help in realizing the goal of an Atmanirbhar Bharat. Ladies and gentlemen, the young minds that come to this campus are fertile and open to innovation. I was pleasantly surprised to know that during the challenging times of the COVID-19 pandemic, the PEC students built robots that could go into isolation wards and deliver food, medicine, and other supplies to patients. That was a wonderful illustration of innovation in the service of society. I am told that two patent applications have also been filed from this institute on COVID-related research. Besides technical achievements, human values have also been amply demonstrated during the COVID times. Organizing a blood donation camp by the students at the time of shortage of blood at the PGI Chandigarh is worthy of appreciation. The PEC alumni too stood together in the COVID times. When they came to know about the loss of income of some parents, they joined hands and made donations worth more than ₹1 crore for the sake of the students in need. Let us all applaud the efforts of those who worked to achieve it. Ladies and gentlemen, I am happy to share that an endowment fund was launched at Rashtrapati Bhavan. 2 years back, I had the opportunity to launch the endowment fund of IIT Delhi. Through this initiative, the alumni could make donations for the betterment of their institute as well as help the students in need. In fact, an amount of rupees 200 crores was committed by the alumni at the launch of itself. Through these endowments, the alumni are participating in nurturing the future generations. It was a pleasure to know that PEC has also established a separate office to foster alumni relations, and it has constantly and closely coordinated with them. The network now links about 17,000 former PEC students together and helps in facilitating donations and scholarships for students. This successful setup is already helping the PEC as well as the students here. There hardly remains a field untouched by the graduates of this institute. From industry, civil services, and defense services to music and entertainment, PEC graduates have made a mark everywhere. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to make a suggestion. The PEC alumni are well placed in their chosen walks of life, and their reach is far and wide. With such mentorship and experience available to them, the graduates of this college are never alone. This mentorship should be extended to other universities of our countries. Last week, a governor's conference was organized at the Rashtrapati Bhavan. in which I had an opportunity to interact with all governors, lieutenant governors, and administrators of the country. I always emphasize that as chancellors of the state universities, they should promote innovation and encourage research and development. In this context, I would expect institutes like the PEC and your competent alumni to act as mentors and collaborate with other universities of the country. The PEC has students from all parts of the country, making it a perfect example of unity in diversity. If an institute can be the unifying factor for such a large set of students, I am sure mentorship from you all can definitely be the unifying factor for our country too. We have always followed the ideal of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. The whole world is but one family. It is desirable that different institutes and universities of our country follow this principle. We need to work together, hand in hand, for greater progress of our country and make a knowledge network for the benefit of all students of our country. I would like each one of you to follow your very own PEC anthem, jisme kaha gaya hai, adhyatma hai, vigyan bhi, sanskar hai, nav gyan bhi, kalpana hai, rachna bhi, parishrami hai, praveen bhi, laksh rashtra nirman ki or. In the end, I would like to congratulate the faculty, students, and all members of the PEC community on this momentous occasion. May you continue to innovate, explore, and excel, and propel yourselves towards greater success. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir, for a very inspiring address to us. May I request all of you to rise for the national anthem. Please maintain your positions till the dignitaries leave the dais. May I please request all of you to stay on your positions? I request all of you to kindly wait for a few more moments, please. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for your wonderful presence here today with us. Have a good day. I request all of you to please join for a cup of tea. I request the audience to please do join us for the cup of tea outside. It has been arranged for all of you. Thank you.